I invite you to the game?
If you want me to try to play it, I can, but to teach it, I don't need to be the one playing. I just need to be the one seeing and able to copy.
All right, so you go to single player then?
It doesn't matter which one you go. I'm going to just talk through and you can ask me any questions while you're gone. Let me holler at John real quick.
Disable the advisor?
Nah, you can keep it on. The advisor gives you good ideas and shit.
Alright, so I'm gonna just put it on new to Civilization 6. That's why I got the advisor on. Turn between autosaves. I'm gonna put 2 times between every autosave. Number of autosaves to keep. Max that out.
Yeah, I'll be having a lot of autosaves on. If I want to save it, I know it. If the game quits before I can autosave, I typically don't be going back to the save games anyway. And even doing that, I still have hella save games. Like, way more than I need.
Alright, so I got quick combat enabled, quick movement enabled, and auto end turn enabled. Should I disable any of that?
Hold on, Ryan. Yeah, he's still on. I'm gonna walk him through a game. He's setting up the settings. Now, you're not trying to play, he's trying to learn, so your game is still good.
Yeah, so I don't want to play right now. Well, I do want to play, but I mean, I'm not gonna play if he's gonna just rush me through the whole goddamn thing.
Ron, don't go to that punk ass tutorial.
Oh, you can see that? Alright, so where do I go to? Scenarios, play now, load game, create game.
That's that monarchy. Ryan, go to,
create a game. What am I doing? Expansion, Gathering Storm, Standard Rules, Expansion, Rise and Fall, Expansion. What am I doing? I know, I'm trying to figure out what rule set. Oh no, I know that part. I'm actually, what rules do you want me in? The Standard Rules or the Expansion? Resources in his territory provide an immunity to 2 ocean cities. Military leaders receive +1 combat strength and attack you for each. Your promotion resource improved in the asset range. Oh, so why we can't see, why can't ever play with the Montezuma again? No, when Jum, whatever Jum you put in, no, they don't give me that option. See, I ain't never known that. Cause did you read what it for his start? So it says luxury resources in his territory providing extra provide an amenity to 2 extra cities. And then it says military units receive +1 combat strength when attacking for each different luxury resource improved in Aztec lands. So for everything I research in my land, my units gain combat strength. It doesn't say anything specific, so luxury resources were like silk, stuff like that. five sons has spent brilliant charges to complete 20% of their original vision. So how would I use the charge? Will I send the builder over to the encampment and push build?
Yep, the same way that you would if it was like building a farm or building a mine itself or a
farm. Okay. And see, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna pick one civilization and I'm gonna play with only this one civilization and I'm gonna perfect one strategy. Me, since I like fighting, I'm trying to pick the right balanced unit that deals with combat strength and fighting, and then also, well, actually now, I'm a dominator, so I'm looking for that. Oh, because I'm, no, I was in John's broadcast, but, oh no, nope, I'm not in John's broadcast no more, so I don't know.
John, can you hear me?
Probably because you're on the phone.
Is John on the phone with you?
No, you're on the phone.
Yeah, which is why I'm saying I got my phone on my right ear. I got my headset on my left ear. I'm on listening to what John's doing on my left ear, and you're on my phone on my right ear. And I'm looking at your broadcast, and I hear in my headset, though, John still and you through
John, not through the phone. Anyway, it's confusing. Let's not really. Oh, no, it just started back because I pushed start. I was going through the settings trying to figure out what
she was
talking about.
Oh, okay. Oh, yeah,
they did. All right, so this is non-capital. So, what would be a good fighting military unit out of everything that we
utilize? I just prefer Genghis Khan, if you like horses. What's her name? Sumerian or Tamaris Tomaris or whatever her name is. There's quite a few fighting armies that can do military stuff.
Because I'm looking at Lady Six Guy. It says non-capital cities within 6 tiles of the capital gain plus 10% to all yields. Other non-capital cities receive negative 15% to all yields. Plus 5 combat strength to units within 6 tiles of the capital. And then it says settling adjacent fresh water and coast do not provide extra housing. Instead, each farm provides an additional plus 1 housing, and plus 1 gold, and plus 1 amenities for every luxury adjacent to the city center. And it goes to say, now you meet ancient era range unit that replaces the archer, strong range attack plus 5 combat strength. I think I might end up going with the Aztecs, but I don't know.
Yeah, so most of these, I don't know what to call them, Mexican-type civilizations, the Aztecs, or those ones, they will give you, it looks like they will give you some type of military strength behind.
Yeah, because I think I'm always going to be a fighter, so I think that's what I'm going to focus more on. I'm a dominator. I think that's how I'll get my advances and my wins. Is to get my units out there, I need to dominate, focus on the lands to build my units, and then attack more. And then I'll take over cities, and that's how I'll get my game. I'm just a conqueror. So I'm not really the religious ruling type. So I'm thinking about Hoyo Tokumi. It says, Lanyards receive plus 5 combat strength in land tiles adjacent to coast. Lanyards receive plus 5 combat strength in shallow water tiles. It says, builds encampment, holy site, and theater square districts in half the time. Well, that's not bad. I'm thinking about being in Japan. Let me finish reading through.
Yeah, so Japan is—it's like an anti-raider. So, like when John plays, sometimes John likes to use one of the second Aztec he went to. He likes to use him, the sixth god or whatever they're called, because they get like bonuses from water and shit. And so Japan would be a good counter city to him because in any of those cities that are on the coast. Your armies would get harder.
Yeah, this is
and then the second one is whenever you fight somebody, once you enter them, an injured person hits softer and an injured person can be hit harder. What it's telling you is that you can hit injured people even harder. And so that's his combat strength.
Strategy I want to go with. Like, I think I want to go domination, but I'm just reading just in case. I'm just trying to find what fits me at this point. And I think I might have to get out of standard rules so I can look at. So, what people do we be playing with when we play the gym? So I can get to that point. Yeah, so which one? Is it Gathering Storm or is it Rise and Fall?
Yeah, it's probably the expansion Gathering Storm.
Alexander the Great, cities do not incur war weariness. All military units heal completely when this player captures a city with a world wonder. Plus 20% progression towards all district, rising to plus 40% if there is a moving pyramid adjacent to the city's center. Plus 50% progression towards range units, all range units go plus 50% combat experience. Lines over strategic resources provide plus 1 production model goals to range resources provide plus 2 gold. She would be bad at building shit.
Yeah, that's why
you're
going to
learn
about wonders.
Oh, yeah, that's probably why.
Like, I don't get bonuses for the wonders, which is why that's what I build. I get bonuses for those districts that take a shorter time to build those. So let's raise all these wonders that everybody else could be building. If I'm going to get my district tomorrow. So that strategy, guys, I know what I'm doing. What my people are good, like, and so if I need to defend, I need the archer. But what am I going to actually join with my civilization? That's different. Let me turn back over and see what John is going to read it.
Yeah, go ahead. I was using Greece last time, so combat victories provide culture equal to 50% of the combat strength of the defeated unit. Those out, and I can keep pushing ourselves, and the more that people fight me, I mean, as long as I win the battles, culture-wise, I'll be booming. It says that Greek get it in the ancient era, so I get it in the beginning of the game almost. As long as I develop military strategy, I do military techniques, I guess. And it says plus, it says Plato's Republic, one extra wild card policy slot in any government. Hey, what does this mean? Explain this to me. What is it? It says Levy Hughes. Someone started pulling that chair further and further away from the cone. Like I said, bro, you break it, you ball it. If I can't sell it, because they don't feel like, hey, you know, this coach put this shit in here. Who? It's on Facebook, bro. I've been waiting for somebody to go and purchase that thing. You take what you throw for a small number of feet. Yep, for a small number of feet.
Even able to run through Egypt like that violently. It just didn't happen. should happen in another way. If you're talking about Hannibal, like, they need to let the boy Hannibal come out, except they probably would want to make him a white character too. But if they let that great Hannibal Barker come out as a motherfucking black unit, then they definitely would have to increase the military bonuses. Shaka Zulu, the empty warriors, that should have been like the very first thing that you're able to get from them motherfuckers who were hella space, just like on Civilization. The earlier version of Civilization got it right when it came to Shaka Zulu. This one, they gave the real power to the foes in the south.
That's what I'm saying, like,
all of that should have been the
like
same.
The Shaka Zulu, like, they don't even get that. We don't even get their bonus movie no more. All thing I see that they get, it says made for them, corps, mercenary city, and armies, nationalism city, earlier, an additional plus five base combat strength. So, base combat strength, is that to the unit, meaning they start off with plus five combat strength? Or is that why they're fucking within the capital circle, they get plus five?
Yeah, so the only thing that really happens is they're good at defending their own little small cities, but once you move outside of your zone of control, which is that colorful line that outlines wherever your city or territory is, once you get outside of that, then you no longer have that bonus. I tell you what though, if you do want a military track, trying to use them and getting good at them would be something I wasn't even able to do. But I know it's something about what technologies do I need to learn in order to form armies sooner. Because once I do hit with those armies, they'll be knocking motherfuckers out the window.
Yeah, that's what I'm looking at. Yeah, I'm going with Shaka Zulu.
Interesting. Yeah, John is almost at 150, and it don't look like he's going to win yet, so I'm going to go on and go to the other one. Whatever his strategy is, it's cool, but the shit took too long.
Hey, hold on. All units receive plus 5 combat strength when attacking wounded units, and they eliminate a unit, they heal up to 30 hit points. That's crazy. Receive a second
level. Only thing, I don't want to bust John's bubble, but the only difference here is that with my religious strategy, I would have already won the game by now. He's doing a whole lot of weird shit, but the game would have been over. He didn't have a religion, and my religious people came in and started converting shit. We already have his capital, and he never did anything about that. And so basically, rather than fighting him, even though he was trying to attack one of my far-off cities, you know, I don't care about that. I'm trying to win the game. If I'm trying to beat your ass, that's different. And so by this point, my battle would have been a spiritual warfare that was already won, because I would have took it to the enemy and converted them, and I'd have been done already. So we're at turn 139 on John. He does play fast, but this shit took so long to get to it. I don't even know how he's really trying to win. Like, this nigga building walls and shit at his city that have nothing to do with nothing.
Hey, so what am I playing on, Mo? I'm gonna go with tomorrow.
Hold on, let me come back over. I can't see him, man. I want your chance for a second. Let me jump back over to Latrell Broadcast, now broadcasting on Latrell's channel. Let me see what we got. All right, I see you. Can you hear me on the mic?
No, I got you on the phone. I didn't even put the earpiece in my ear yet.
Oh, because I can hear myself coming through here.
Hold on, let me see. Hello, say something. Can you hear me? Say something more. Alright, hold on. I'm going to mute the phone. I'm going to mute my phone so you can hear me through the game and I can hear you through the phone. Alright, so can you hear me now? Hello? Yeah, I can hear you through the phone. But I was trying to see if you can hear me through the mic. Oh, you know what? I didn't send you a party invite. That's why. Hey, T, can I send him a party invite through while I'm broadcasting?
Nah, don't send a party invite. That's broadcasting. That ain't gonna allow me to keep switching back and forth.
Yeah, see, I put share party audio on, so.
Yeah, but that's
I'm trying to figure out why he can't hear me through the headset. No, just broadcast. He can see what I'm doing. I heard you, Mo. Give me 2 seconds.
Did you pick your character?
No, not yet. Hold on.
No, did you decide who you wanted to be at? Like, you were reading them
all. Oh, yeah, Tamarius. All right, Mo, I sent you a party chat invite. That way, because I don't want the phone to die. Hello, can you hear me?
Yeah, I hear everybody now. I'm on my head.
I still can't hear you, though. Mo?
Yeah, because I have my headset on mute, but now I got it. Can you hear me now?
Yeah, we good now.
Yep. So the most important part of this game is typically the beginning and how you start. And so because you're creating your own match, let me give it a second for my screen to come in full.
So you want me to hit start game right now or?
Hit square.
Alright.
No, hit square.
I did.
Hit box. Oh, there you go. This is what we be talking about when we stay setting up the board. So go down to city states. We scoot that over to the left. We want less city states.
How many?
Like, we use like 3 or 4.
Alright.
Go down to disaster intensity. I said 3 or 4. Why are you going to then turn around and ask the same question? Let's go. There you go. Disaster intensity is a thing that will cripple you while you're trying to learn. You can learn from it early by keeping it on 2, but one is probably more than enough when it comes to disaster intensity for you to learn. Go down to the maps. We do Pangaea, so if you want to learn on the same map that we were learning on, it's Pangaea. So press X and you can change that one.
All right. You keep going. I don't know you probably waiting on yours.
Yeah, over to the there's the one. All right, now where it says tiny, that's cool. Go down to resources.
You can keep talking, Mo. I'm already there. You just waiting on your stream to catch up.
Oh, okay. Go over. Press abundant.
Alright, what about world age?
Alright, and then from here, rest of that shit doesn't matter. We don't touch none of that shit. Hit the square button. Oh no, there it is. Damn it, I missed it. It was players up top.
What's up?
My bad. Press circle. Go back. Yeah, so this one's different than the one we're able to start. So, yeah, you got to go back out of all of this shit. You're in the wrong create game mode.
Okay, I'm lost.
Press circle back. Go all the way back to the main screen.
All right.
Go to multiplayer online and then run that route. Yeah, not single player. Go back to the other one, the multiplayer online create game. Yep, internet. Hit the options button, like the start button, to create game.
Yeah, you can keep talking through it. I see your screen take a little bit minute to catch up, but I'm
private already. Game. Make sure you hit the X on that one, and then reset those same settings. So map is Pangaea, the map size is tiny. Hit the city states down, and then the disaster is down. Make sure it's abundant resources, and then hit the start button. All right, now you're familiar with this screen. After you set your person, be sure that you go down to where the computer's settings is. They should not be on Prince. When we're still learning, those folks need to be on Settler. And then you should be ready to go. Yeah.
All right, and then what am I doing now?
Oh, and then you press the start button. You go back up to where you're at and you press start. Thank you, babe.
Of life beneath water, to the great beasts of the Stone Age, to man taking his first upright steps, you have come far. Now begins your greatest quest.
From this, Ron, you should have started a different party than John's, because he's broadcasting, and I think what we're talking about is coming through on his.
He joined the party that we're. I'm about to say, all I gotta do is you can mute John Mike if you want.
And may your friends be true, just as your enemies falter.
See, I know how to play Civ. I don't know how to mute that nigga though.
All right, what we doing? I'm settling right here out the gate.
I mean, that's about as good as I see it's going to be. I always just settle my city wherever it is, for the most part, right? Yep. That's just whack, but you can make it work. Now, this is an important decision. Whichever direction that you move towards is ideally, where do you want to see your second city in which part of the world? Hold on. So right now, Wait. Go up to open technology tree. There you go. Now, on the open technology tree, you see the different things that are there. If they told you that there was a specific unit that you needed to create, this is the technology tree in order to get to that ability, or to open that ability for them.
It says to boost this, I need to kill 3 barbarians.
Who is the actual unit that you needed to create that you wanted to
fight? I went with Temerius. So, all right, so, yeah, let me, I probably should start off explaining about Temerius. All right, so I went with Temerius. Temerius, all units I have now, automatically get a +5 combat strength. Now what happens is, when I wound a unit, I naturally become stronger than that unit, so I gain additional strength after I fight a unit, and then once I beat them, I restore plus 30 points back to my unit automatically. Hello?
And for some reason, because I'm in the broadcast and listening in as a part of the group, it creates a doubling effect on the microphone. So I hear you say everything twice.
Oh, I think I probably did say it twice. All right, so it says allow harvesting of bonus resources improved by farms. Allows harvesting of cattle, sheep, and deer. Let me see, what do I have around me? So, grasslands, only, let's see, bonus. So, rice is the bonus resource here. And then this requires mining, but I can't filter the rice for food. That requires, okay, so my next thing, my next best thing is going to be mining. Yeah. Because I have three places where I can mine, and I can collect the rice food without that. All right, so yeah, so my next, yeah, I'm going to have to discover.
And so what is your question?
No, my question is, so for where my city's at, like looking at the resources that are surrounding me, pretty much it says this requires mining. So in order for me to get through this stone, it requires mining. And then
there you go.
And then it says the mercury luxury resource requires mining. So all three of these things require mining. And then I only have one thing with food, which I can just go, a builder, I can just chop that down. I don't need to resource anything. So because I don't have any animals close by and I don't have anything else, plus I see diamonds over here, so yeah, so I'm gonna go with mine.
Ryan, you're gonna have to call me on the phone. Hopefully you got a charger for it.
Oh yeah, and no, then, the phone fully charged,
because I need to log off of the group chat. It's creating a crazy doubling to where I can't even hear what you're saying.
Yeah, so what it is basically you're watching the broadcast, and then I also have you in a party chat. So I can mute you. All you gotta do is mute one of them. So you can go in the party chat and mute my voice in one of them, and then it'll still allow you to hear me on the other one. No, I... Okay, yeah. All right, then, yeah. Oh, you know what? Hold on, let me see. Hold on, I think I can fix it on my end, because I think if I stop sharing the audio. Yeah, now I'm going to stop the party audio. So I'm going to include the microphone audio in the broadcast, but as far as... So did it fix it? Can you still hear it doubling? You can go back in the broadcast. I already fixed it. So basically, I was sharing our party audio with everybody talking. And I'm also sharing the broadcast audio. So I just left it on the broadcast audio. So everything you're saying to me within the broadcast, they'll still hear. But they won't hear what we're saying in the party chat. Well, I don't know how to mute it inside the game. I only know how to mute it inside the party audio. Yeah, so all you do is hit the middle. All right, so hit the middle button on your PS4, go to party, and then go to the party, and then all you do is go down to my name or your name, click X, and then click mute chat audio. Yeah.
So then that would have been the only part is once I converted him, where the hell was the Aztecs? Because I hadn't even found them niggas yet.
All right, Mo. So what I'm looking at right now, it says, all right, so I think my best bet is to build a slinger.
Slingers suck.
Well, they defend my city because I'm sending out my barbarian unit.
And I they get don't them defend 16. The city. They get their ass whooped.
John, be quiet.
Oh, there we go.
When I ask you for help, you want to rush me through it, motherfucker. So just listen if you're going to listen. Hey, Moses. So if I build a scout, I got you, John. I heard you. So if I build a scout, I'm going to build a builder. Or is it a builder or a monument? All right, you heard me, Mo? Where in the hell did Mo go? Why is my teacher leaving every 5 seconds? Moses. I'm gonna go with the builder.
All you gotta do is mute me, he says. Now he's, why did my teacher leave? Motherfucker. I didn't leave. You just couldn't hear me no more.
Alright, so.
I wish there was a way to mute the broadcast so that I can hear you through the headphones, but not need the broadcast audio. So, your plan number two failed too. How do I mute the broadcast? Because muting you didn't work.
I cut it back on. I cut all that back on once you muted me. I thought it was gonna work, so. Let me see. All right, so when I'm looking at my audio sharing setting, it says include microphone audio and video clips, or include microphone audio in broadcast. It says include microphone audio from the headset or PlayStation cam. And then it says, share party audio. All right, Mo, so I think the next. No, you just started jumping in and you started yelling something through the microphone. Mo had already answered the question. I told you I heard you, though. I acknowledge that I heard you. All right, that's 2-2. Mo, can you see what I'm doing? All right, so craftsmanship or foreign trade, how do I determine which one of these I do? It says allow a creation of trade routes. It says unlock diplomacy, join ongoing war, diplomacy, joint war, policy, kind of wars, policy, and even though I can get that in 7 turns, I think it's better I go with, I'm gonna go with craftsmanship. Yeah, I think you got a big delay. All right, so now that I have my builder, so now I think I'm gonna build my monument, or I can go with a cellar. But I think I'm gonna go with the monument. Can you hear me? Oh, you ain't saying nothing. Well, you gotta let me know if this is a good idea or a bad idea. But look, I got barbarians. Next time, move your builders where you gonna move your builders. Oh, fuck, I'm not even gonna be able to catch these motherfuckers, am I? No, I'm not. I'm focusing because I want to hurry up and get my swordsman. I picked the says discover a second continent. Let's see, military tradition or state workforce. So I picked a fuck. We're gonna fuck around and get away. All right, so L1. Yeah. All right, so I went with, what you call it earlier, but hold on. Hold on, let me. Yeah. So the unit I need to build right now would be, there they go. They got my spearmen right there. And I'm gonna rush them out. And then now I'm gonna start building my settler. Yeah. I'm listening. Yeah, well, see, that was the purpose in the unit I picked. I know you weren't here in the beginning, but no. It was you weren't in the same party as me and Mo at first. Mo was talking to me on the phone, and I was talking about the reason I chose this unit. There's a reason I chose this unit. So I got what you're saying, but the reason why I chose this unit is what you're missing. So what this unit does is I get +5 combat, period. All right, so I get +5 combat, and every time I wound a unit, I increase my strength against that unit. And then every battle I win, I get +30 overall health back anyway. So I'm putting these units out there and I'm fighting them on purpose because one, I'm gaining experience faster. Two, I don't have to heal them as much. And three, I can actually move them out and get to those barbarian units because my tactic is basically military based. I'm aggressive, I'm a fighter, so I'm just gonna stick to that, like you said. So I'm getting my units out to get to these barbarian encampments, because once I get to barbarian encampments, that boosts my whatchacallit towards like research or development, like towards science. So like right now, like I've already discovered steel, I've already discovered whatchacallit, so I can go wheels and get chariots, or I can go, you know, I mean, I can do a couple different things from here. But right now, I'm going to start focusing on science, because now that I have that, I want to develop more science in order to get to, let's see. I don't know if you're watching the broadcast, but it says selling. It says boosted. Found a city on the coast, and I found a city on the coast, so I boost. I lowered the turns that I can develop selling. So I can get selling in 3 turns because I found my city on the coast. I can get pottery in 2 turns, whatever that is, in 2 turns. If I find a natural wonder, I can get astrology in less than 5 turns. It'll lower my astrology from 5 turns probably down to 2 turns if I find a natural wonder. And then right now, it says masonry. It says build a quarry, and I, you know, boosted the build on a quarry, and I get masonry in 5 turns. I get a wheel in 5 turns. So it says mine a resource. So because I've already mined resources, I can get wheels in less than 5 turns, which I'm going with wheels anyway. And then now I already have my seller unit, and I'm pushing my seller unit toward this area over here. I'm trying to get to where I can build this encampment, but I can't build this encampment right now. In order to build this encampment, it says no suitable location in the zone district. So, I think I'm going to work on another seller. I can get another seller in 5 turns. But I think I'm going to put out a spearman and then put out a seller. Fuck, how in the fuck is this unit of 40? Yeah, there you go. No, they ain't put me out. Well, I'll explain to you in a sec. I'm gonna need animal husbandry because they over there, they got sheep now. So I'm gonna need that. And then now I think I need to go ahead and build I got a whole nother unit right here already too. All right, so it says make your dedication for the classic era. So this is the part I don't really understand too much either. How do you know I'm in a dark era? See that. So it said I need more houses in Pangea. I'm gonna go foreign trade because I can get that in one turn. I'll always do this one. Yeah, what happened to Mo again? All right, so what is this saying, Mo? It says, quest, destroy barbarian outposts within 5 tiles. So what do I do? So how do I... No, I'm not... I want that. I don't know what else to ask. What are envoys? No, I didn't. Huh? Have a good day. Hey.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm on the game. Girl, like, you getting no bigger. You look so big on camera. All these secrets. What secrets? I don't know no secrets. I don't know what you talk about. You gotta talk to your dad about that if it's that time. You need to talk to your dad about that. If it's that time, you need to talk to your dad. I don't know nothing about no secrets. What happened? Who's that? Yeah, what happened?
Yes,
ma'am. Mo?
We just got here. Didn't I use it?
Can you hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you now. Oh, well, you just kind of answered that question for me. I said it because it gives my own city production. For me, yes. I mean, I could be wrong. Maybe that's a teaching moment, but. Yeah, plus I'm fighting two encampments, so.
You should say thank you when you have those type of opportunities.
I'm still trying to find this. I'm still trying to find this encampment that, Yeah, she's talking about the ones I just killed, though. I'm looking for whatever this encampment was that this person was talking about.
Kalova, your second city, started off as a 1 over 3. It's now a 2 over 3. That is the second worst a city could have started off as.
And that's the direction I went to. That's why I rushed the way I did, cause so I could get the horseman. This nigga got it sewed up over here. Just one second.
Hello?
Thank you. Thank you. pokazujesz więc swą prawdziwą naturę. Wąż wijący się w trawie. Łatwo zdeptany.
Thank you. entek nenshahu erhe per embach pai en. Pai ek meshahes.
Thank you.